Hi, I'm Dr. Cary Goldstein. I'm the founder of the Goldstein Dental Center here in Atlanta, Georgia. We're now going to take the bulk reduction diamond and we're going to remove everything within that depth cut. We always start with the occlusal surface first. That way, when you're moved to the sides, you've got less cutting to do from the occlusal. Now, you can have your patient close and look at the amount of reduction and make sure that you've got about 1.5 millimeters here. Remember, we've still got more to reduce. So we've got our reduction on the facial and the lingual surfaces. Now let's try and go interproximally. And you can use this burr, or if you find that it's too close, you can always go to a thinner burr. Let's start with this one first. I don't know if you can see right in here, but we want to break the contact and make sure that we see some tissue below that opening so that we know that our material, when we take our impression, is going to capture that margin and there's a space between the two teeth. You using this same diamond, you've got to also make sure that you place your second tier or your beveled aspect to the cusp tip. Because remember, this tooth comes straight up and then it bevels in towards the lingual. So you've got to take your burr and make sure that you remove about 1.5 millimeters of that surface as well. We're going to do the same aspect on the lingual. And you've just about got your prep now when you look down right on there. Let's go ahead and try and smooth it up a bit. You see we've got a little sharp angle here. Let's make sure that when we look down on it that we've got nice draw, which we do, as I'm looking right down the center of it, but I'm just going to try and smooth things up a little bit. It's a little difficult with plastic and a diamond, as you can see. It leaves a little dark mark. Still got to get a little bit more space here on the distal. So when we look at this preparation, notice you can see all of the little grooves in here. Do you want to remove those grooves and get a polished surface to your crown prep? I don't think so. I like leaving it nice and rough on the occlusal surface and the sides so that the cement is able to penetrate into these areas and give us a little bit more cement retention. Now, if you'll notice, once again, take a look at this tooth. We've got plenty of space here, so we're able to leave this super gingival. Talk to your patient about it. Let your patient know that, yes, when we're finished, you might be able to see a little bit of your natural tooth. You can always go a little bit further if they don't want to see that, but try and leave it super gingival so that it's easier for you to check at every hygiene visit. It's easy to find out if there's any leakage. If you go subgingival, you're going to always have the problem that you're never going to be able to see that margin. So let's take a look at our reduction. So when you put that together, you see you've got nice space for your ceramic material. And notice that we've left on the occlusal aspect, it's angled inwards, and we're going to smooth it just a little bit more so that you've got plenty of room for the anatomy of that particular crown. Let's finish just a little bit on that occlusal. I saw that little line angle there, right over here, because we want to be able to put some occlusal anatomy. Good. And the final thing you'll do is just turn your burr onto the side and round out these angles. Porcelain does not like any sharp edges. So the more you can round this out, you're going to get a better fit of your crown restoration. Notice by doing a super gingival, it is very easy for your technician to see those margins. You'll never have to have a call from that technician that says, "Can you read the margin for me?" So that is my ideal prep now.